Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is your host Majestic speaking, coming to you with another episode of MechWarrior Online here. And today we're going to be playing with the Arctic Wolf 2 variant. This is a 40-ton clan medium mech, and right now we're playing Conquest on Crimson Strait. So right in the beginning of this match, we're going to head over to Epsilon and try and flip that cap. So at least we have a 3-2 cap, put it in our favor so that it puts a little bit more pressure on the enemy to get a little bit more aggressive if they want to beat us in this round. So again, we're only starting off here. I see that the rest of my team is grouping up, pretty much going through that tunnel right now, and I'm the only one out here, so I do have to be careful. As you can see on the right, we have six SRM2s and 2 medium pulse lasers to work with. Very, very splat, very, very pinpoint, and a lot of DPS to put down. So I'll go into the details of that when we get back into the mech lab. But for right now, we're just going to group back up with our team. We flipped the cap in our favor, and now we do have the advantage. So that's what we wanted to have. And it forces them, if they haven't already tried to make a move already, it's going to force them to get down. They're going to have to get down off that platform at some point, and they're going to have to duke it out with us if they're going to take our caps. We do have a good positioning here as well. Now, they can push over the top and maybe take one of the other points from behind our lines. But I think that we'll be able to handle this. I was on comms a little bit, so I was telling everyone, we have this commando behind us. Let's make sure that he doesn't pop up any UAVs or any give away any kind of information and turn us around in that capacity. But we were able to get him down before the enemy realized and pushed over the top to get some of our guys in the back. So that's definitely a good sign. But we just need to be careful. And this Blackjack looks like he's pushing up a little bit, trying to get some shots down. He did put down a strike. I believe that was him. If not him, one of his buddies that were right there. But he's pushing up a little aggressively, and he's by himself. I'm not entirely sure if that's a wise move on his part. But now we're going to just peek in the tunnel, and we're going to put down a huge salvo into the tunnel, splatting whatever was in there. I saw the little icon above the head, but couldn't make out exactly what mech we were firing at. But we did put down some damage nonetheless. Something with racks. Okay, it has racks, and I'm with my big boys next to me, so I'm not really worried about being targeted per se. But we do have a fast mover here. This is a completely mastered mech, so I'm not scared to get out of the battle very, very quickly. Now, I'm just focusing up on the end of the tunnel here, because it did look like whatever opponent that was that had the racks was kind of pushing towards the end of the tunnel. And we do have, is that that's our little fire starter there. It looks like he's firing in on the tunnel here. And you know what? It looks like he might be moving in, so I'm going to give him a little bit of support here. Now, he's going for this Warhammer, so I'm going to focus up on the Warhammer. Juliet is a Bushwhacker. We do have to be careful, and I'm not entirely sure if my team is helping me out here, but it looks like we did get that Warhammer down, so that's a great kill for us, especially to take down one of their big boys. That Kodiak did happen to take off my right and left arm, so I did lose 2 of my 4 SRM2s. Now, I do still have 2 more in my torso and 2 more in my center torso. So, again, that's where the positioning is of those. But the 2 SRM2s that are in my arms, those just got taken out. So we need to be sure that we're pushing in appropriately going forward. That was a bad play on my part. I thought that we were going to push in on that side, but it looked like their heavies and assaults that were in there got the better of us there. It looks like we might be getting a little bit of push here from our friendlies. Yeah, we're going into this Kodiak from behind. Cord out on the center torso on both sides, both the center on the front and the center on the back. So he goes down. Now we're focusing up on that Stalker and the Bushwhacker. And along with him is a Timberwolf. So we have 3 mechs piled into this corner, and we do have a tremendous amount of support now. Now we're just providing amplification support and constant DPS. This Bushwhacker is going to try and get away from us, but we're going to constantly put some fire into his back as well. And now we're pushing out on the other side of the tunnel. Just going to take a quick look up on the platform to make sure no one's shooting down on us. But now we're going to move in back towards Theta. So we have this Direwolf that's right in front of us. That was a Warhawk. I'm sorry. A Warhawk that was right there from his profile. I got him confused. But we have that Warhawk there. We have that Roughneck. And this Warhawk needs to go down. I feel like he's providing a lot of support for his friendlies that are circled around him right now, along with a couple lights that are around him and a couple of mechs with jump jets, like that Huntsman that's trying to put some fire down. So we're definitely spreading the damage out pretty well. But I'm not going to focus up too much entirely on just one mech. I'm going to put some fire down on that Nova Cat who gets taken out, and I do still have my friendlies with me who are helping out on some of these other mechs that were with him, and there goes our Gargoyle pushing up, but we're going to help out on this Blackjack. That might be the Blackjack from the beginning of the round who somehow made it to this point. It is 8-5, and we did get yet another kill there, and we do still have the cap advantage. So this match is looking very, very good so far. Going for this Bushwhacker. We're going to peek up behind him if we can. But unfortunately, we have that carcass in the way, and I do not have jump jets on this mech. Unfortunately, that would have been nice to pop up there and get some shots into his back. But now we're going to go for what's in front of us, and he actually wound up killing himself. So I'm not sure if it was an overheat or what, or maybe a crit shot entirely, but he finally goes down. And now it's just looking for the last guy on the battlefield. We have the cap advantage. It's 3-2 right now, and we also have the score advantage. So we're up by over 100 ticks. And now we're just going to focus up on Alpha, and we get the final kill on that Huntsman, taking off that component, that torso. We didn't even get time to target him. We just shot, and that ended the round. So a great round overall. Conquest here on Crimson Strait for the first round. Excellent gameplay. 3 kills, 9 assists, 3 KMDDs, 766 damage with 8 components destroyed. Over a half a million C-bills earned for that. Wow. So great stuff here. Looking over here. Yeah, this was, as you can tell, this is a little bit of an older video. Pulling it out of the archive here with that that 42 tag still on there. So, yeah, pulling it back. Great round, great teamwork. But now let's head back to the mech lab and go through the rest of the details of the build. Here we go. Alrighty, guys, welcome back to the Mech Lab, where we're going to go through the details for the build on the mech I have in front of me, the Arctic Wolf 2 variant. It's a 40-ton medium clan mech. It is not an omni-mech, meaning that the configurations of the components are hard set. You cannot swap them out and configure it in a way that kind of suits your style in regards to weapons, but you can, in fact, swap out the engine. So there is a trade-off there, but out of all of the Arctic Wolf variants, now there are 6 different variants of the Arctic Wolf that you can take out on the battlefield. I love this one the most, and I'm going to go through that in just a second, but let's check out the overview on this mech. It has 0 ballistic, 2 energy, 6 missile, 1 AMS, and 0 ECM. You already know what the loadout is based off of the last round that you just saw on the battlefield, but let's go through it. Let's actually check out why I did exactly what I did. So I have a Clan 270 engine in there, meaning it goes 117.5 kph. That is with speed tweak. This mech is completely mastered. As you can see my skill tree here, just so you know. We're going to dive into this in just a second. So you can see, obviously, I'm very heavy with the missiles right there off the bat. But this mech having 6 missile hardpoints, you have to take very light missile weapons if you want to configure it and fill up every single missile hardpoint on this mech. You get 1 in each arm, 2 in the right torso, and 2 in the center torso. The rest of it has just 2 energy in the left torso and that AMS hardpoint up here as well, which I am not utilizing. This mech in particular kind of reminds me of a faster version of the Inner Sphere Blackjack. Now, if you guys have ever played the Blackjack, you know that that's a pretty flimsy 40-ton Inner Sphere mech. And this mech kind of reminds me of that, just because you cannot have a lot of face time with it. It's a hit-and-run kind of mech, so you want to have a bigger, beefier engine, but when you do hit your opponents, you want to pack a punch, and that's exactly what this mech does. It serves its purpose in 3 different ways. You have the SRM-2s, which have the fastest fire rate of all the missile weapons. You also have the medium pulse lasers, which provide pinpoint damage, and you also have the spread fire and shaking of the cockpit, which both the missiles in conjunction with the energy hardpoints can provide a lot of damage up close to any opponents that you encounter, you know, face to face. So that's really what the goal was here with building this mech. It's not necessarily a brawler. You don't have a lot of face time with your opponents, but the damage that it does put down, when it puts the damage down, is both pinpoint, spread fire, and constant DPS. Again, those are the 3 things that I focused on. Then I just filled up the rest of it with SRM ammo, double heat sinks, and just making it more and more heat efficient to take out there on the battlefield, because obviously cycling through SRM-2s and the medium pulse lasers, the heat definitely adds up after a while, so we have to be careful. But that's the reasoning behind this build, and I figured it would suit it pretty well, considering what we do know about this mech and how it is a little fragile. So it's not necessarily for everyone. You don't see them out on the battlefield a lot, but it still serves its purpose, and it's a real blast to play, and can do some serious damage if you know how to use it. So take every word I'm saying here with a grain of salt. It might not be for everyone, but I'm saying if you do have them and you want to configure it this way, give it a shot. It's a blast, and you'll see in the upcoming two rounds, if not already from the first round, that this is a very enjoyable mech to play in the end. So consumables, I decided to go with two cool shots and an advanced artillery strike. This build was made pre-patch, so, you know, the configuration and the rounds that you're seeing are actually pre-patch, so I might, you know, revisit it, and, because I know that, like, with the arty strikes and the cool shots, I'm having a little nerf involved there, might not be the best utilization of my of my skill points, so I might have to come back and revisit this now, but in the meantime, that's how I configured it, and it still is a blast to play. I have taken it out for a couple rounds, and it still serves the same purpose that I wanted it to, even post-patch. So, diving into the skill tree, though, very heavy on the firepower side of things here. We do have the high explosive missile spread, missile rack. You just want to fill up this mech with as much firepower as you possibly can. We're not going to amplify much when it comes to survival. As you can see, we didn't do anything on there, and I'll explain that in just a second. But, you know, to have a majority of our firepower coming from the SRM-2s, you know, we want to make sure that we're amplifying that damage as much and as we possibly can by amplify it between, you know, all the missile spreads and the high explosives and everything like that, you know, for crit damage and so forth, and also the heat efficiency. So bolstering the heat generation and the you know, the cooldown and the velocity and everything, just to make sure that it's not only firing very fast, but it's heat efficient, and you know, the velocity, the missiles reach their target a lot quicker so that we can get out of there and we don't have to put in any more face time with our opponents. Moving over to the mobility or survival tree, both of these I'm going to put up on the screen here for you. Survival, again, is based off a percentage. So percentage of, you know, your armor, your structure. And really to amplify the armor and, you know, the skeletal density on this mech really just didn't seem worth it to me. I'd rather use it for mobility and the firepower for what I am using it for. Now, some of you might not agree with that, but when you take into consideration percentages, percentage-based per node, adding, you know, armor or density to your mechs, it's just not worth it. It's kind of like putting speed tweak on, you know, an annihilator. It's, you're just not going to have that kind of payout that you're looking for when your speed is only amplified and increased based off a percentage, not a set amount, like, you know, adds 5 hard points overall, or adds 10 hard points or anything like that. It's and same with speed tweak. It's adding a percentage of the speed, not you know, not hey, you're gonna add 5 kph to your mech if you unlock this node. So, you know, I hope that explanation kind of clears everything up for you guys as to why I didn't invest with it. I know that I talked about it being a fragile mech, but it's just not the best use of your nodes if that's what you're looking to do, and that's exactly what I was looking to do. And you'll find that if you decide to build it the way that I have it, I decided to invest heavily into mobility. Just because obviously we want to dip in and dip out of you know, tough situations pretty quickly. If we need to draw the attention away from the enemy really quick, we want to be able to continuously fire, get away very quickly, you know, all that good stuff, if you will. So again, with the speed tweak amplifying at 1.5%, you know, per node, that's where we're getting the bonuses from. So we have you know, 7.5% on top of the base you know, speed that the Arctic Wolf 2 was set with. So that's what is able to bring it up to 117.5 kph. Operations, I wanted to make this mech as cool and heat efficient as possible, and also be able to survive, you know, in shaking the cockpit. So I did add the cool run, the heat containment, and improved gyros. Those are the main three components of this thing, specifically because we have that close range kind of combat. When we get hit, we don't want to jostle the cockpit too much. And obviously, as I mentioned, we do have a bunch of external heat sinks on this mech, 6 to be exact, 3 in each torso. So to provide cool run and heat containment, Those kind of go hand in hand with why I'm using it. Auxiliary, as you saw before, I do have the extra consumable slot, just the general consumable slot extra. So you could choose, your cool shot in one, and then either an advanced artillery strike or a UAV in the other. Unless you go all the way down to here, in which you can unlock two cool shots, and then put the third cool shot or the third slot as your advanced artillery strike. So that's exactly what I decided to do with it. I hope that this overview was kind of I know it was a little bit of a deeper dive into the details behind it, but I just wanted to explain my rationale as to why I decided to configure it the way that I did. I really, really enjoy this mech. But now it's time to head out to the battlefield. We have a couple more rounds to do, ladies and gentlemen. So let's head out to the battlefield now, again in the Arctic Wolf 2 variant, Clan 40 Tonner. Here we go. Alrighty guys, here we go. Second round of gameplay is actually going to be the final round of gameplay. We're going to show one more round of gameplay just because this one really encompasses what this build was all about, and the third round really wasn't that informative for you guys as the viewers. So we're just going to hop into this one. It is on River City, again playing Conquest, and we're just peeking around the corner right now of the Citadel. As you can see, look at my team. We are so well grouped together right now. This would be a tremendous push if we went around this corner. So we're going to play it safe a little bit for now. Just make sure that we have the caps. So it's 3-2 right now on the caps. And we do have a couple mechs that are scattered around the battlefield. But right now we have this King Crab right in front of us. He's just trying to get back into cover, but we are able to get some shots into him. This Atlas Juliet is pushing around the corner very heavy. Now I'm trying not to be the focus of his attention, knowing that I have a lot of my teammates behind me, but we're going to try and keep putting down some damage nonetheless. So we're really, really pushing our luck here. But actually, we're going to push up on this ramp and just see if there's anyone up here who's getting some shots into our friendlies back. And yeah, there's an Arctic Wolf right across the way in front of us. So we're going to try and make him retreat a little bit. They do have a couple other opponents that are on the far side as well who are trying to get some shots down. But we're going to try and make this a roll. We're just going to, rotate or NASCAR around this Citadel if we possibly can. But I cannot be in the front. I already have one of my arms crit that will only lose an SRM-2. But we're going to fire in on this Atlas. This Atlas is taking a beat right now, but I can't turn around because then he's going to have a clear shot at my back, and I don't want that, so I'm going to have to face tank him, which I know a lot of you may not agree with right now, but we're just constantly putting that damage into him, taking off both of the torsos. All he has is a medium laser left, and I do get some support from my friendlies. Guys, I got very, very lucky right here. There is no doubt about it. That was not a skill play. We just face tanked and hit all the buttons, but I did have some friendly support, and we finally got that Atlas down. He was pinned in a corner. Now we're going to help out on this Orion, taking him from the flank. He's focusing up on one of my friendlies, not even paying attention to me, and we're just getting a tremendous amount of damage into this guy, and finally he goes down. Right now it's 4-2. Looks like our opponents are swinging around on the ramp. We're getting a lot of damage down though, so I am pretty happy with how this battle is unfolding. Even if we do lose, right in front of us we do have this rifleman who is able to crit out my center torso SRM-2s and take off my right arm. So we did lose 3 SRM-2s right there, but now I'm going to push up onto the platform with this Nike that's right next to me and hopefully get the shots in that we need to take this rifleman down. Yeah, the rifleman is focusing up on him, so I'm just going to keep putting in my shots down, and he's going to retreat back around the corner. Now, I don't want to stand here in the middle in case he comes back. And he does come back, and he actually gets a shot on my center torso and my left torso from the back. But we put a big shot into one of our opponents that was in front of us, and he goes down like a sack of potatoes. So that brings the score right now to 6-4. So it's pretty evenly split. They do have the cap advantage, a very heavy cap advantage. Right now it stands at 4-1. So we're going to have to make quick work of these guys if we even want a shot before time runs out. And right there, that Arctic Wolf is still there. He has quad SRM-6s on that thing. And one of our lights is poking him a little bit, maybe trying to crit out some of his torsos. And that's what I'm going to go for too. He does have a cord leg as well. Hopefully we can get him down. Yeah, there goes one of the torsos. If we get this other torso, he's going to go down. And yes, there it is. 8-6 right now. We have to keep moving, guys. We have to keep up the pressure. Otherwise, we are going to lose. We're going to lose very, very heavily. But we did get one of the caps back in our favor very, very quickly. So it's only a 3-2 cap. Not over yet, ladies and gentlemen. Focusing in on those torsos now. Finally, we get the final kill shot on that Hellbringer. Now going for this Arctic Wolf who's in front of us. Another one. So we're going to try and get some back damage on him. He does have a cord left torso from the rear. But now he's going to swing around the Citadel. And there is that Rifleman again. This guy just doesn't go away. And again, we're just going to keep peeking in on him and either turning away or fleeing the scene. Right now, looking at the health of this mech, Cord Center Torso, if we could get him down, hopefully we can. And there he goes. Finally, he goes down. So it's either we're torso twisting and trying to spread that damage out, or as I mentioned before, we're turning away entirely. We're dipping in, dipping out, and just getting our shots down when we have the opportunity. Now it's 11-7. We have a 4-1 cap advantage with only one opponent left. Now, it would be wise of him to try and just escape the battle entirely and maybe run this clock out, because they do have almost a 300 tick advantage. But we're going to take Sigma, and he just gave away his position at Kappa, so we're going to head that way and maybe help out and hopefully get this guy down so that we can secure the cap, get the advantage. If we get the kill, we will get the win. So there he goes, Charlie, right in front of us. It is that Arctic Wolf from before. He's still running around on the battlefield trying to keep himself alive. We are now narrowing the distance, though. Just getting a little bit of a cheeky shot there in between the buildings on him. And again, he is battling with one of our friendlies over here, a light mech. So we're going to have to help him out and amplify the damage a bit if we're going to have a chance at getting him down very quickly before he can escape. And there's a big shot into one of the torsos. And again, we're just going to keep spreading that damage out. Looks like he is laser focused on one of my friendlies. So we're going to get some free shots in on this guy. Now, we did core out both of his arms. Not entirely sure what he has in those arms or the torsos for that matter. Looks like we took out one of his light machine guns. And again, one of the three pillars is constant DPS, and that's what we're providing on this guy. Looks like that torso is about to pop, so his speed will be cut significantly, and everything is cored out. Now he's completely useless, and finally he goes down, and we did have a 5-0 cap advantage to take the win. Wow, man, did that escalate very, very quickly. Thank you so much to the teammates who went around capping in the meantime, and the rest of us who went and hunted this guy down. 3 kills, 7 assists, 10-13 damage with 4 components destroyed. A crazy round, nonetheless, out of this mech. An absolute blast to play. And I feel like this round in particular signified what this mech was meant to do if you decide to use it for yourselves. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. That's going to be technically like a 2 and a 3 round. I feel like that round was good enough to equate to 2. But that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. Please feel free to hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, check out the links in the description. I'll be looking at all of your comments and questions. I know I've been ignoring YouTube for quite some time now, but I really want to get back in the swing of things. For those of you who can't stay tuned for the Twitch streams and everything, so again, I do apologize for that. But here's an official video. I know a lot of guys were looking for the official videos to come back, and here they are, ladies and gents. We're going to put some Twitch stream highlights in as well, but not only highlights from now on, all right? So we're going to be switching it up a little bit. Thank you guys so much again for all the support. I really do appreciate it. And I look forward to seeing you all on the next one. Take care, guys.